Hey, what's going on YouTube? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and on this channel we discuss and break down popular music video effects and techniques for creative edits. Today we are going to be breaking down this glitch pop-out effect that you can make in Adobe Premiere Pro and Adobe After Effects. This effect is great for when the kick or the snare drum hits in your music video. It's also really good used in other creative ways as well. I'm going to show you guys how you can create this effect and then customize it to your liking. So if you're excited about learning this effect today, definitely hit the like button down below and let's get into it. So I thought the best spot for this effect in this video was right when his hand is really close up into the camera. And this is where I decided that it would be good to have the pop-out effect happen because it also happens to line up with the snare drum. So what I'm gonna do is at this point where the snare drum hits is just hit C on my keyboard and make a cut there. Something to remember is that this beat is hitting really fast. It's a very quick, snappy beat, so this effect should be the same. It should be quick, it should be snappy. So let's go about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 frames to the right there and make another cut. So now we have this section of our footage where this effect is going to happen and it's all cut out. Now what we're gonna do is hold option on our keyboard and drag this clip to its own layer above itself, and we're gonna right click on this new clip, hit nest, hit OK, and then right click on it again and say replace with After Effects composition. So this is gonna pull our raw clip here into After Effects, and all you need to do to start this effect is come up here to your Rotobrush tool, click on your Rotobrush tool, and start highlighting the area that you want to have start to pop out. So for us, it's gonna be the outline of his figure. I'm just gonna click over the areas that I do want the program to trace, and then I'm gonna hold option and click over the areas that I don't want it to trace until it's refined. So I've just finished tracing the first frame here of our clip, and now if I hit 2 on the keyboard, it's gonna cycle to the next frame, and you can see that After Effects does a great job of just automatically tracing our outline here. If you wanna learn more about rotoscoping, I highly suggest watching one of my most recent rotoscoping videos on my channel. I'll include a link for that below if you want a little bit more in-depth tutorial about rotoscoping and rotoscoping techniques. So now we can see we're at the last frame of this cutout, and we have it traced every single frame. So what I'm gonna do is come back to composition. If you don't see this transparent background behind your layer, whatever it is that you cut out, you wanna make sure that you have your transparency grid toggled on, which you can find right here. And now what we're gonna do is just manipulate the scale of this cutout. So we're gonna increase the size to make it look like he's popping out a little bit more. So we're gonna hit S on our keyboard with this layer selected. That's gonna pull up our scale value, and we're just gonna increase this to 115%. And that's just gonna make him a little bit bigger, which is gonna give us that pop out effect. Just hit Command S, and that's gonna save it back into Adobe Premiere Pro. So now we have our rotoscope layer right here and then our background layer right here. So we're kind of making a sandwich with these layers. So the goal of this effect is to place something in between the background and our rotoscoped layer here. So what we need to do is just drag our rotoscoped layer up to its own layer up here to video layer 3. And now we're gonna put a glitch effect or some type of overlay texture in this space right here. So I actually have a pack of motion texture overlays, which you can download on my website, and it's got a bunch of cool overlays for videos and video edits. So if you want to check out this texture overlay pack, I'll include a link below. But for now, we're just gonna use this glitch 3 overlay, and we're gonna put that in between our layers. So we're gonna click and drag this glitch 3 overlay and place it in between our layers. Now you can see the background is all black. So what do we need to do is just decrease the scale of this layer a little bit until we get those edges appearing where we want them. Because this glitch is a lot longer than this effect, I'm just gonna speed up this glitch effect to 300%. So I'm just gonna click on this glitch overlay, hit Command R, and speed this up to 300%. That's gonna make it shorter and faster. And now I'm just gonna drag it over, and I'm just gonna bring the edges of this glitch in so we have the same duration as the rest of the effect. Now as I scroll over, you can see we're getting this crazy pop-out effect as we go from the original clip here, and then we go into where this effect is happening. You can see how he pops out, and then we kind of get that glitch behind him. You can manipulate this rotoscoped layer however you want. You can place other effects on this cutout of him, and you can get very creative. That's why I think rotoscoping is one of the most powerful tools in the Adobe suite. Personally, with effects like this, I like to throw on a little bit of an echo. So I'm gonna go over here to my effects panel, hit effects, and I'm gonna type in an effect called echo, and I'm gonna throw that onto our rotoscoped layer. It's gonna look like this at first. It's gonna look really funky. We need to change a few things over here on the left side. The first thing we're gonna change is the number of echoes. I'm gonna change it from 1 to 4. I'm gonna leave the starting intensity at 1, but I'm gonna bring the decay down to 0.7. And now what I'm gonna do is change the echo operator from add to composite in front. So now when I scroll over, we can see how those echoes look frame by frame. So they look pretty sick, right? It's just another way to add a little bit more of a visual element to your edit. So now all together, let's see what it looks like. He ain't got no business in here. If you are a video editor and you're interested in joining a community of other creative people, definitely consider hitting the subscribe button down below. We're coming out with a lot of really great tutorials and visual assets this year, and I want everybody who visits my channel to be a part of the journey. These past 30 days on my YouTube channel have been life-changing. It's been amazing watching how this community has grown, and I appreciate every one of you who likes, comments, and subscribes to the channel. The support means everything, and it keeps me motivated to keep making content like this. If you're a video editor who's interested in adding some sauce to your visuals, definitely check out my website, venturevisuals.com. I have overlays, transitions, and a bunch of other stuff on there that I've designed for video editors like myself. And I also have a free pack on my website as well. So I'm gonna include those links down below. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. It means the world to me. And until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.